Hello friends, in the last video we have seen the respiratory pigments. Today we are going to discuss the transport of carbon dioxide in blood. The carbon dioxide is produced as a result of complete oxidation of nutrients in the mitochondria of the cell. The amount of carbon dioxide generated is dependent on the metabolic rate of the organism and the relative composition of the nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins and the lipids. The carbon dioxide is carried from tissues where it is generated to the lung for exhalation in three ways. It is either dissolved in plasma, buffered with water as carbonic acid or in the form of bicarbonate ion, or bound to proteins in the form of carbaminohemoglobin. First, dissolved in plasma. Carbon dioxide is 20 times more soluble in plasma than oxygen. However, only 5% of carbon dioxide is carried in the plasma due to the low solubility of carbon dioxide in plasma. This solubility coefficient is just 0.03 millimoles per liter per mmHg, and the lack of carbonic anhydrase activity in the plasma. The solubility of carbon dioxide in plasma is inversely proportional to the temperature. That is, as temperature increases, solubility of carbon dioxide decreases. Second point, buffered with water as carbonic acid. Carbon dioxide combines with water in presence of carbonic anhydrase from RBCs to produce carbonic acid as water plus CO2 gives carbonic acid that readily dissociates into bicarbonate ions and H+, that is proton. The carbonic anhydrase is present in kidneys, eyes and brain in addition to RBCs. The carbonic acid readily dissociates to bicarbonate ion such that the ratio of carbonic acid to bicarbonate ion is 1:20. The carbon dioxide diffuses easily from plasma to RBCs and vice versa, but protons and bicarbonate ions cannot. Therefore, there will be an increase in the osmolarity coupled with increase in cell and lysis of cell if protons and bicarbonate ions is not maintained. So also, increased proton H+ ion concentration prevents formation of bicarbonate ions. Hydrogen ions bind with and are removed from the plasma by reduced hemoglobin. That is, hemoglobin from oxygen is released. Reduced hemoglobin is less acidic than oxygenated hemoglobin. This is Haldane effect, which states that at any given partial pressure of carbon dioxide, the carbon dioxide content of the deoxygenated blood is always more than the oxygenated blood. The bicarbonate ion diffuses out of the RBCs while chloride ion moves from plasma into the RBCs in a phenomenon called chloride shift or Gibbs-Donnan equilibrium, or which is also called as the hamburger effect. The antiporter anion exchange transporter, that is band 3, is involved in the chloride shift. Third, in the bound form to the proteins or in the form of carbaminohemoglobin. Carbon dioxide combines with the uncharged terminal amino group of hemoglobin or other plasma proteins to form carbamino compounds as follows. RNH2 plus carbon dioxide, it gives carbamino compounds plus protons. About 30% of the exhaled carbon dioxide is carried in the form of carbaminohemoglobin. The transport of carbon dioxide in the form of carbaminohemoglobin is non-significant in televosts since there is acetylation of terminal amino group to which CO2 binds. The acetylation of terminal amino group is absent in elasmobranch and other vertebrates. Lampreys lack transmembrane anion exchange transporter, that is band 3, in their membranes. As a result, RBCs of lamprey have high carbon dioxide than other vertebrates. The carbon dioxide binds with terminal amino group of beta chains where they are in competition with organic phosphates for binding sites. Thank you.